So you joined the military, but why did you decide you wanted to be a helicopter pilot and a Black Hawk helicopter pilot to boot? Why didn't you say, I'll take an easier job?
Well, I thought I was going to become a linguist, David, because I spoke Thai and I spoke Indonesian and I studied French until through college. So while I was being getting ready to be commissioned, you sat down and you write down what you would like to do in the Army. And then the Army decides what they want you to do. And I remember sitting in the classroom as the only woman in my ROTC unit when the instructor said, all right, you can write down whatever you want, but whatever it is that the Army needs, that's what you're going to do. So guys, you have to put down combat jobs. Even if you are an accounting major and you want to become a finance officer, you can put down your request to become a finance officer, but you still have to put down infantry, armor, artillery. A certain percentage of your choices must be combat positions. Except for Duckworth, and he called me out specifically, except for Duckworth, women aren't allowed in combat. So Duckworth, you put down whatever you want. And I remember thinking that this was just inherently unfair, because not for me, but for the guys, I was gonna get equal pay for an equal rank, but the fact that I didn't have to face the same risk was wrong. And then I did my research and I realized that women could serve in the air defense artillery and in aviation, with helicopter pilot being the most likely job, combat job open to women. So I put that down as my first choice, took the aptitude test, scored off the charts on it, and that's how I became a helicopter pilot.
Okay, so you're in the Army National Guard and you've learned how to be a helicopter pilot, but there is no need for you to go to Iraq, but you actually volunteered. You said, I want to go into combat and I want to go fly helicopters in Iraq. Isn't that unusual?
Well, what I said, which is not unusual, was, my unit can't go off to war without me. And I had just finished a 3-year stint in command of the of my Black Hawk unit, the Bravo Company of the Mad Dogs. And I just finished being their commander. And I was their commander all through 9/11. And I'd been preparing them for war, knowing once 9/11 happened, that it was very likely that we would go to war. I always thought it was going to be in Afghanistan. And so I knew the unit was going to eventually go. And 1 month after I was rotated out of my command position, the unit was caught up. And that's when I called the battalion commander and said, sir, I can't be the only Army aviator in the Illinois National Guard standing safely at the state headquarters, waving goodbye. I'm going to go. How can you take me? This is, there's no way. But it's about being part of the unit.
And what did your husband and your mother say when you said, I'm going off into combat, but I don't have to, but I'm going to?
My husband understood because he's a soldier as well. Mom, of course, did not understand. I just told her, Mom, I have to do this. This is what I'm supposed to do. My dad did not say much at all, but he understood and he didn't question me. You know, he was a career military officer as well.